My name's Greg. I'm one of the lecturers here. And today I'll be talking about games at Deakin, and specifically our Bachelor of Game Design and Development. You will be commonly familiar with entertainment games, Minecraft, for example. But there's a whole range of areas that you can use game development skills in, like the simulation industry, for example. So simulation for military, medical training. So with the rise again of virtual reality technology, using that technology to allow surgeons to train and apply their skills in a virtual environment rather than a physical one, because ideally you don't want to be practicing on actual people. But another point worth noting is also that the skills you learn in a game development course, or the skills you need to build games, are extensible. It's not just in the games industry. Interactive web media, mobile and app development generally, artificial intelligence, virtual reality, augmented reality. We cover in some way all of these things at one point or another. And these are all separate industries unto themselves. So I suppose the takeaway message is that game development skills are widely applicable. If you're doing a games course, you're not just pigeonholed to games necessarily. You can take these skills elsewhere. Another aspect of games is they are uniquely interdisciplinary, which is my favourite aspect of game development. You've got creative people working with technical people. Right? It's unique in that way, I think. It's challenging. It's hard work. Game development is difficult. I won't lie about it. It's not easy, but it is incredibly rewarding. And it's dynamic. You don't know where it can take you. Right? My own game development experiences have put me in all sorts of interesting, unusual situations that I might not have been in otherwise. It is also worth noting that we do include in the games Bachelor of Game Design and Development coverage of a whole range of basic IT skills, right? And more advanced IT skills. I mean, databases, programming generally, project management. So you do walk out of here with a well-rounded set of IT skills, right? Because, I mean, game development is... it has a lot of commonalities with any kind of IT development. You're still managing projects, right? There are probably going to be databases involved in there somewhere. So as I mentioned at the start, just because you're doing games doesn't mean that's all you can do. There's a whole range of things you can possibly do. And the skills that you will learn in a games course, if you can program games, right, you can program for anybody. The idea of making a game and putting it in the hands of someone is sort of, and having them enjoy it, is sort of what drives it. It's about creating experiences. That's what game development is. So they can be for entertainment, but as I said, you can create virtual experiences that are for training purposes, for simulation. That is a growing aspect of the industry. It's not as visible because these things tend to happen inside large organisations rather than dedicated external companies like Australian Defence Force, for example. They have their own in-house simulation arm. The FBI in America, for example, they have their own in-house simulation group working on these kind of things. But ultimately, you are creating experiences. Right? And as I said, game developers are passionate. If you love making games, you really, really love it. So thank you very much and enjoy the rest of your day.